Infosys Foundation will be 25 years old in December. And when we started Infosys Foundation, I did not know much about my own country or philanthropy in a systematic way. At the end of 25 years journey, I know what my country requires, what I realized about my own country and what poor people really aspire in life. It connected me, poorest of the poor people in my country. So I jokingly, I say, when I started foundation was a baby, I was the mother. After 25 years, foundation is the mother and I am the baby, because it has taught me so much in life. Compassion, you know, connecting with the people, understanding somebody's difficulties a lot more than if I would not have done foundation, I would not have understood so much. Because when I look at poor people, I always feel I have a duty towards them. And that has kept me rooted, because I'm not swayed by awards, achievements, all those things. Because you can get an award, you can get achievement if you work hard, that is fine. But more than that, you know, I feel philosophically that I come from a middle class family, and this kind of a money has been given to me for a cause, and that cause is to help others, and particularly poor people. And that's the reason when I look at poor people, it reminds me, they remind me actually that I have a duty towards them. And that has kept me rooted and head on my shoulder. Name a project which is useful to people which we have not done. Name anything we have done. Building a road, making a pond, helping the farmers, working with the sex workers, building schools, toilets, water project. Name a thing. 14 national disasters and one pandemic we have handled in 25 years. So that philosophy probably in my mind that a generosity of few is hope for million. A generosity of few, hope for million, is probably embedded, you know, in that, I suppose. Few things. Number one, that was a great help to me. That was my parents. My parents at that age moved to Bangalore, stayed ground floor, and I stayed first floor. So there was somebody who were taking care of my children, because for any mother, other than her, the next person who can take care of her children is always her mother. You have freedom, and you know it's easy to deal with your mother. I never depended on servants or any other domestic help. It's only my parents and my sister, who is a doctor, she took care of my both children. Second thing, I always worked part-time when they were small. Like my children, when they were young, my children used to go to school, so I would work between 9 and 12. When they went to high school, I worked between 9 and 4. When they left home for higher studies abroad, then I worked full-time and overtime. So I always adjusted my schedule, cutting my ambition so that I should be available for them any moment of time. That is second. Third one is, you know, you should also understand your role is different at different time. At least I did that. As a wife, I have some role during you know, building Infosys. And my expectations were low in marriage. My husband should take me abroad, no. My husband should earn a lot, no. You know, my expectations today, what happens, your expectations are very high in marriage. My expectations are quite low. Like I said, Murthy, if you don't earn, still it is okay. Both of us can earn and make because of the simple living. Fourth one is building a company may be difficult, but most difficult was telling children when there's a wealth and lead a simple life. That was most difficult actually. Children know, because every day the press writes about your wealth, and still you should tell children to lead a simple life. That is more difficult. And that I did, leading by example. I myself led a simple life and I could tell them. Okay. Building an Infosys was, of course, fun, I felt, because that there are a lot of difficulties, but that whole journey was fun than the money. Because money, I never expected. It was something like a jackpot, I feel. See, if you are a working woman all the time, you know, you want to excel in both areas. It's natural because we have been educated, we are in that field. But what children require, that you should understand. And that's the reason I never felt guilty. I realized children require a quality time with the mother. Today, what mothers do, most mothers, I don't say all, because of the guilt, whatever children ask, they give. Because you always feel guilty. I am not able to spend time with them. Instead, what they ask, I will give. That I did not do. I said, I rather spend quality time with you, but what you ask, I will not give you, unless it is really needed. Like my son, I told him, you will not get a huge TV until you finish your 12th class. He said, okay, then you also should not see TV. I said, fine. I did not buy TV until he finished his 12th class. The day he passed out, I bought, and then he left abroad for his studies. We have to understand it by substituting with material things. The guilt feeling, you in psychologically you may feel fine, but it is not good for children. What you should do is, you do your work in the office, but remaining time you should be with your children. Remaining time you should be with your children. I never attended wedding parties, office, get-togethers and all. I said, no, I want to spend my time with my children. And be a child with them. You know, you read, they will read. You go out with them, take them on a holiday, teach them what you want to teach. And children require a company until they are 14. Afterwards, they don't require. The first 14 years of their time, you must work extra. After that, you should become normal. And then you can be used out when they are 20. Then it's okay. You have to work extra because you are a mother. And sometimes you feel, why father will not do? Fathers also will do, but child is more attached to the mother, and that's the reason there is a mother tongue. I feel actually women play a greater role in the society because she is a great manager. As a daughter, as a sister, as a wife, as a mother, as a daughter-in-law, as a mother-in-law, she has many roles with different human relationships. Okay, as a boss, as a subordinate, again, now in modern days, I will add that. So she manages all the relationships by and large very well because it's the inbuilt quality of a woman. Okay, women are really inbuilt managers. They have a lot more patience and they know how to manage human relations. If you look at this, there is a survey of the most successful men. And 70% of them agreed it was the family atmosphere at home was so nice, they could concentrate on their work. If woman supports a man, then only he can build a company, he can be successful. Okay, woman has a soft power or passive aggression in a way because she influences her children. She makes her husband to aware of many things in marriage. Particularly softer skills and more compassionate things. And in a long marriage, actually 40 years, 50 years of married life, or even after 25 years, you can see a man when he was married after 25 years, he's so changed because of the influence of the woman. And if you do in a correct way, in a proper way, okay, you can really make a great influence in the society. Without celebrating, without talking, without, you know, without even boasting about your achievements, she can silently change a lot. And that is the reason when a woman does all these things, our ancestors have told, Yatra Narya Ramante Pujyante Tatra Devataha, where woman is respected, okay, such families, such societies will be prospered. Where women are ill-treated, such societies, such state, such families will suffer because there is a bad influence on children. If you ill treat a woman, your children will become bad because they see that one. Of course, it's a scar on their mind. It is a scar on their mind and they should not repeat it. They should not repeat that. What has happened, you cannot undo, right? What has happened, you can't undo. But you should understand helplessness of women and they should be much more compassionate. I always feel you should be more compassionate if you come from such families, because you have seen the brunt, you have seen how women suffered. You should not make such errors. And you should be more understanding, and that will lead probably your children in a better state. And again, I will tell women, you know, you should have knowledge, you should have education, you should have confidence, and you should face it much better, you know, much better than domestic violence, because there are a lot more helps are available today. But it's not easy. That also I know, because I worked with domestic violence people. It is not that easy, but it is much better than yesteryears, because you have a helpline. You have many, many, many ways to resist that today. There's nothing great about me writing a letter to J.R.D. Tata. It's great about J.R.D. Tata reading that letter, I consider this way. It was in the year 1974, and I got admission to do my M.Tech in my PhD abroad. And I determined to go. And just I was casually going through the notice board. There I saw that Telco, which is known as Tata Motors today, requires young, bright engineers who can work hard. The remuneration is very high, etc., etc. At the end, bottom, like it is written, women candidates need not apply. It's like, you know, cigarette smoking is injurious to health care. I was young, I was bright, I was bold, and I got very upset. How can they do that? I came to my hostel room, took a postcard, and I wrote saying that if somebody else does this one, I understand, but Tatas are always ahead of time. And how can gender discriminate? And in a society, when there's 50% of the people are women, and if you discriminate like this, such society will not progress and such country will not progress. I was surprised how Tatas could do, and posted that to J.R.D. Tata. I did not know his address. I wrote J.R.D. Tata Telco Bombay. That's all I wrote. Actually, it was totally wrong address. The real address is actually he was not in charge of Telco. In charge of Telco, the chairman was Mulgaonkar. It should be Yes, Mulgaonkar, Chairman Telco, 24 Homi Modi Street, Tamarind Lane, Fort Bombay 1. This is the correct address. I just posted that postcard, but it reached, because JRD was so well known. It reached him. And when he read, he called his people and told, please call that girl for an interview, because a girl from a small town, because I come from a small town known as Hubli, neither I had money nor I had connection. Very simple, ordinary, middle-class family I grew up. So he said, a girl has written, we should do justice to her. You, at least you test her technically. You can't write like this. Then they called me for an interview. I answered all the questions. Then they offered me a job. Then I went home and told my father, you know, on the way coming back, I said, I got a job like this. And my father asked, what are you going to do? I said, I'm not going to take. I'm going abroad. My father said, then why did you write? I said, I wrote because no girl should be rejected because she's a female. He said, you have opened the Pandora box. Now, it's your responsibility that you take up a job and pave the way to others, saying that, yes, girls can get job and they will also do well. He said, you have opened the new argument and they have given you a job. And if you don't take up, they say, look at the girls. They get a job and they don't join. And he said, if you go abroad, you may do very well, but you will not do justice to the cause what you have asked. Then in those days, we used to listen to our parents. Mm-hmm. And I tore my admission letter. And then I joined House of Tata. One is my parents and my grandparents are responsible for what I am today. Number one, my grandparents were in a village, and my grandfather was a school teacher. He was extremely fond of learning. And he told Beta, the day you stop learning, you will become old. Age is only a number, okay? But the day you stop learning, you will become old. My grandmother told, if you are not compassionate, then you are not a human being. The difference between an animal and you is that you are compassionate. You are expressive through your words, through your deeds. An animal cannot do. The difference between a pashu or animal and manava is a compassion and communication. So she said, if somebody is in difficulty, say few good words. That itself is a great compassion. My father was a doctor and an atheist. And he told me, my patients are my gods. They are not in the temple, masjid, or in a church. When you serve, when you do your work sincerely, God resides here. Then he told me, what makes a woman stronger in the society is education. It's a magical wand. If you touch, like Cinderella kind. He said, we are three sisters and a brother. He said, I have four children. And marriage is secondary, primary is good education. Education makes them bold. My sister is an MD doctor with a gold medal. I am M.Tech with a gold medal, BE with a gold medal and M.Tech. My sister is IIT Madras with a gold medal. My brother is IIT Delhi and he went abroad and professor at Caltech. He said, I will not give a luxury life to my children. I rather spend the same money on their education. Education is must for everybody and particularly for women. So in the year 1968, I decided I want to do engineering. The whole society said no, because in our community, known as the Madhva Brahmin community, nobody went for engineering. I come from a small town, going to engineering was a taboo. People thought I'm crazy, and many people told my father, the girl is mad, but father is crazy. Or the girl is crazy, father is mad. How can he send an 18 years girl to a college where there are no engineering students, girls are there? How can he send? My father said, I have faith in my daughter. She's not doing anything wrong. She's not running away. She's not doing any illegal act. She's doing something which she wants to pursue, that is the study of the applied science. So my both parents felt it's important to pursue study and learn and expose ourselves to the modern world and communicate with compassion and do our work sincerely. There's nothing wrong in that. They are good managers, but have patience. Have patience in life. Don't get upset very fast. Have patience. Patience pays a lot in life. Something goes wrong, don't get upset immediately. Give some time to cool. When you are making any decision, sleep one night on that. Tomorrow morning you make the decision. Don't make quick decision. Take time. Have patience. And women as such, we are very compassionate people. Because we have been wired like that by God, by nature. Okay, we have been wired. Compassion is part of woman's life. Don't lose it by any method. Keep compassion always alive. Have patience. And then you work. You will be successful in life. Don't worry about 39, 40. It doesn't make any difference. 40, 41, 42 doesn't make. As long as you are enthusiastic to learn, as long as you know you are able to, actually, more the age, it's much better. You'll become much wiser, much mature. You know, my grandmother at the age of 62 learned how to read and write. At the age of 62. And when I became 60, I decided I want to do something which if I would not have done engineering, what I would have done. As my grandfather was a school teacher, we were very fond of history. So I at my 60th birthday, I enrolled myself to Indology classes. And I enjoyed. Age, you should not worry about age. It doesn't matter how you look, because however good looking you are, the nature won't spare you. It is going to affect you, and which is not in your control. Which is not in your control, you should not worry at all. Which is not in your control, you should not worry at all. Okay, can I become 20? No. Then why worry? Okay, wrinkles will come. Yes, it will come. I can't control. What you cannot control, you should not worry. What you can control, you worry about it. In life, many things we cannot control. Actually, I will tell you. Okay, that you should not worry. What you can control, I can work hard. I can You convert my every unit of time to useful thing. Okay, every unit of time I want to convert into something which I want to do. Third thing is learn to live in a team. Learn to adjust and live in a team. Fourth one is keep your goal always in front of your eyes. You may be delayed by 1 year, but still you achieve. So what? You may lose the battle today, but you'll win the war later. You have to win the war. Always you have to win the war. For that, it may take a little more time, but you will. But don't, your lakshya should not be neither to lie right nor to left. Next testrosam, next sinstrosam is said in Latin. Keep your mind fixed to that and work accordingly. Then only you'll be able to achieve. And have peace in mind. Have peace or content in mind. Content in mind gives you a inner strength so much than any external things. I always examine myself and get strength from within, not from outside. Actually, women are much better positioned than previous, I mean, our generation, because you have women grievance cell, then you have sexual harassment, departments. They're much better. I want to tell women something and then I'll tell men. Women should understand they are much better positioned today than our time. Nobody would understand when I will tell, I need, because they said, what is this? Have a woman and a lot more problems. Yeah. Okay. Today, women are much better positioned, but they should also understand. Never play a card. Okay. I'm a female. I want more concession. The more and more women ask so many concession, then as an organization, then you feel better to have men. The more the concession we ask, we are making our road closed, actually. Because any organization, we should do perform very well. All the time you are going to ask a lot of concession and leave, etc. Then if they say it's better to have a man who will ask less concession and work productivity will be more, they think. So women should not use this card. I'm a female. I want all these things. Yes. If you are a woman and not working, then you can be with your children, you can be with your parents, you can be with your husband, you can do all those things. But when you are working and you are getting a salary equal to a man, then you should work like a man. Don't play that card. I'm a female. When it comes to work and when it comes to salary, take more. No, it is not correct. But you have to ask certain things which are only meant for women. For example, if you are traveling around 8 o'clock in Delhi, maybe even 7 o'clock, I think, you are alone after office, there is a work and you are staying there. After 7 o'clock, then you must ask the management, somebody should drop me. Okay? There is nothing wrong in that because the situations are not safe today in India.
Yeah.
Okay? Yeah. And as much as possible, management, don't keep female employees late as much as possible. Because it becomes a problem to you. I'll give an example. When I was young, I was 27, 28 years old. Every day at 5:30, my office used to be over and I used to go. One day at 6 o'clock, I came down because I was doing a little late. And J.R.D. Tata came down from this first floor and I came down with him. He knew my maiden name, Kulkarni. He said, Kulkarni, why at 6 o'clock you're still in office? I said, sir, my husband is going to come. So he's late. So I'm waiting, I'm late, little late. He said, I don't like any female to stay back. It was in the year 1974. He said, any more female employee, I don't want, they should work after 5. Any work is there, let them finish by 5. Let them have a little less lunch time, doesn't matter. But let them finish by 5:30. After 5:30, they should not. He said, okay. I said, no, sir, it's okay. And I only stayed. He said, no, you also should not stay. And it was evening and he said, he stood there. And I was feeling embarrassed. He said, no, Kulkarni, I'm going to stay until your husband comes in this building. He could have told anybody, you stay until the car comes or the taxi comes. So we couldn't afford in those days, those things anyway. You wait until her husband comes. He said, no, you are the only female here. I can't leave you on the ground floor and the pavement and go. I will stay. And I said, no, sir, he will come. He said, no, I will wait. And Mr. Murthy came, he said, young man, don't make your wife to wait for you long time after office. That was a lesson to both of us. that if you have female employees, as much as possible, do not keep them after office. That means don't give an opportunity like this. Okay? But if it is required, keep them in a group. Keep them in a group. Send them in a group with somebody, you know, because whatever said and done, today's scenarios are not safe scenarios.
True.
Then you will regret it later for small things. Yeah. So there a woman should play a card. I can't stay alone. I'll stay with my group. I can't go home alone. Somebody should drop me. Okay. But during office hours, she should not play any game. So many women will say, you know, in our Infosys security also, ma'am, we can't do night duty because security, female employees are there. Well, call centers also. We can't do. I said, why? No, it will affect our family life. I said, no. If that is the reason, then don't take this job. If, you know, we should also know where to stop it. They don't want to do night shift, then they say, our family life is there. Her husband gets upset. Then I said, don't take this job then. Then take a job 9 to 5. You cannot have cake and eat it too. Okay? But when company provides everything, then you should not say, I can't do this job. Then you can't do. So we should have do's and don'ts both. That's what I want to tell. And always make, you know, pay, you know, if you are in a campus, Mr. Murthy took care. In our campus, every 30 meter, I think, or 50 meter, there should be a big lamp poster and the lamp. So that you could recognize the person and everybody, should, you know, a security should be posted in every some meter, something he made. So that children, you know, we have a training center, children, they study there and come back. You should see the girls walking in a group and there will be a security man. Okay. You have to make all those things. It's not a waste of money. Some management says it is a waste of money. No, they are not. They are essential. Essential. Okay. We are not in Sweden where you travel after 12 o'clock in the night, your bill will be half. If you are a female and travel after 12 o'clock, like once he told me that taxi driver, if you are a female and, you know, and take a taxi after 12 o'clock, you will get half the charge or something. I said, what a nice thing. But we are not in Sweden. We are in India. What we are here, we should adapt that one. We should know our limitation and work in that. Still, you can work very efficiently. Yeah. I have seen my girls working between 8:30 to 5:30, 100% efficient. They don't have to stay extra.